So now we're gonna get into what we eat in a day. We've eliminated all these things and you're like, well, what the heck do they eat?
Totally.
So we start our day off with 32 ounces of lemon water, and that's pure filtered water. We use a Berkey water filter, and then we do a full lemon. You could also do lime instead of lemon. And then we go into 32 ounces of celery juice. So we'll wait, I have one right here. Ben hasn't drank his yet. We'll wait 20 to 30 minutes after we're done with our lemon water, and then we will have our celery juice. He's been waiting to drink this just so we could show you guys. So we get down our 32 ounces of celery juice, and then you wanna wait at least 20 to 30 minutes before you eat anything.
And then we move on to
the heavy metal detox smoothie.
And so the heavy metal detox smoothie is what is going to remove all these metals. So it's like the lemon water, like, flushes the liver, kind of sets the stage for the celery juice. Mm-hmm. The celery juice comes in, dislodges the metals, the heavy metals, and then the heavy metal detox smoothie.
It's gonna come in, like, sweep it all up.
This is the heavy metal detox smoothie, and this comes in and sweeps out any sort of metals that are floating around.
Then usually right around when we're doing our heavy metal detox smoothie, we'll take our supplements for the day. What's important that we learned with supplements is it's best if you don't have any fats in your system. So doing it in the morning before you have any fats throughout the day is important for your body to really absorb the nutritional value in the supplements. And then it's also important it is attached with some sort of glucose. So that's why we like to do it when we're doing our smoothie, or maybe when we're eating some fruit after that celery juice, so that we know it's going into our body with some glucose and with no fats.
The glucose is like the delivery service. So it's like, you know, it gets in with the glucose, glucose takes it to the liver and all the other organs that need it.
Yeah, exactly.
And then usually after the supplements, we'll move on to like a secondary sort of drink that maybe we'll sip on throughout the day. So we'll usually kind of make that and get it ready for the day. We might not drink it right after the heavy metal detox smoothie, but at least it's kind of ready. So what are we drinking today?
Today I made us the medical medium cranberry waters. Those are really good. You can look that up online. Most of the time, I'm definitely at least making us a honey lemon water.
Yeah,
at least doing the honey lemon water. And then if not this, you know, once we finish this, I'm usually making us a honey lemon water.
But you can make like teas. You can make, you know, ginger water. You can make thyme water. Thyme water is a great one because it's antiviral. You could also just drink some coconut water. You know, that's a great one. You should be drinking every day throughout the day anyways.
Yeah. Hydration is really important. So if it's just water you prefer, make sure you are putting something in it to make it living. So whether that's lemon, lime, orange, cucumber, some sort of like living thing to make it a living water.
And then, so after we've made these, we usually move on to
some fruit.
Some like breakfast. This is like our breakfast, really. So
our second breakfast, because the smoothie
is filling.
Yeah.
Yeah, but this is like our fruit bowl.
Yeah, I did. It'd be like whatever fruit I bought. This one has blueberries, strawberries, and mandarins today. So that's kind of like our snack, you know, before lunchtime.
Yeah, we'll also do like during the summer months when melons are in season, mm-hmm. we'll like buy a ton of melons, and then we'll split a melon in half, and then she'll get half, I'll get half, and that will be like our breakfast.
Yeah, and we'll do that. So that will do the 20 to 30 minutes after our celery juice and before anything else, because melon is best to consume on an empty stomach because it digests so quickly.
Yeah. And then you could also switch it up, you know, when melons aren't in season, you could just eat some apples. You know, apples are great for the liver.
Yep.
So we got some apples over here.
We always keep a bunch of apples on hand because this is also a really good go-to snack. I feel like apples and bananas are like our go-to snacks when we're hungry.
Yeah, and if you could go to the market and get some apples, they're even better because there's no wax on them and they taste a lot better.
Yeah, so if you get them from the store, you want to make sure you really scrub the wax off the apples.
Yeah. And then for lunch, we typically will do, you know, one of two things, really.
It's, yeah, we keep it, it's pretty straightforward over here. It's either a really big salad with lots of leafy greens. We try to get a, you know, different variety in all the time. And then with whatever toppings, so like tomatoes, cucumbers, radishes, bell peppers, onion, fresh garlic. You know, we'll put some herbs on there in our dressing. We'll keep it fat-free. Our go-to is maple syrup with lemon and garlic powder. And if it's not a salad for lunch, then it's a
smoothie.
Yep.
We do the smoothie. Or like yesterday we had spinach soup, which is a favorite. We really enjoy the spinach soup. And so, you know, lunch we keep it pretty simple. We just do, you know, smoothies is always easy. You can just buy a bunch of fruit from
frozen fruit
from the store and then just keep it in your freezer and then
pack a bunch of greens in there.
Put a bunch of leafy greens,
spinach,
you know,
or kale.
Yeah.
Or even like I'll put radish greens in there too because those are really great. So I'll put those in our salads or even our smoothies. And then I'll do like ginger, fresh ginger, bananas. Sometimes I'll put fresh aloe leaf in there, but you can keep it really simple. Just frozen fruit, leafy greens, some bananas, filtered water or coconut water, and boom, you have yourself a smoothie.
Yeah.
Really easy.
And that's something that you could make in the morning, which is cool. So if you're like busy working throughout the day, you can just prep everything in the morning. And then you'll have it ready for you throughout the day and you don't have to spend time running around getting all the ingredients and putting them in, you know, and then blending. It's all done for you.
Yeah.
So.
And this, the medical medium spinach soup, that is really good. It's a raw dish, so it's a cold soup. I will admit, the first time we had it, we didn't care for it. But that was when our taste buds were still getting used to all of these new like plant foods, and now it's something we love. And what works for us is we like to keep it raw until dinner time, so that's why we're still consuming raw for lunch. But for some people, you know, you might need cooked foods, and there's still ways to heal with that, just like steamed potatoes, Brussels sprouts, things like that.
Sweet potatoes.
Yeah, squashes.
Starchy stuff.
Good starches.
If you really need something to really fill you up, you can always do some oats as well. You know, for breakfast, just have some cooked oats and
some oatmeal. Yeah, and keeping the fats out.
Pile it on with like dates and fruit,
maple syrup
as
really
your sweetener.
Good.
I mean, like, you can.
You don't need the fat.
You don't need the fat, right?
So
that's the whole goal with this cleansing is the minute you incorporate fat into your cleanse, it stops the cleanse. You can't cleanse anymore. So you want to eliminate the fat as long as you can before you all of a sudden need it. You know? So the next thing we have typically after lunch is just snacks. So we'll like snack on fruit, we'll snack on veggies. Anthony's got some great adrenal snacks.
Yeah, that's really important too, is taking care of your adrenals. So the step one to taking care of your adrenals is snacking every 1 to 2 hours and never getting yourself to the point where you're feeling really, really hungry and starving, because then that means your liver is starving and your body is releasing adrenaline. So make sure you're continually snacking, always keeping your glucose levels at a good level, and then you have nothing to worry about. But we all go under stress, adrenaline, and that means we're wearing out our adrenal glands. So we want to incorporate adrenal snacks to repair the adrenal glands.
Mm-hmm.
So what's like the top one we go to?
Top one is, got it right here. So we take some dates, and we take a celery stick and some apples, and we'll throw a date in our mouth, take a bite of that stick of celery, take a bite of the apple. You're getting your mineral salts from the celery, you're getting the glucose from the apple, you're getting the glucose here from the dates.
Potassium from the dates.
And potassium, and they all work together, so.
Those three things make up an adrenal snack.
Yep.
Another good one that we really love that we haven't had in a while, and I'm gonna have it today, and you can have it too, it's berries with honey and then a little bit of celery juice. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna eat my mandarins, and then I'm gonna drizzle honey on my berries, and then I saved a little bit of my celery juice, and then that's an adrenal snack right there.
Yeah.
So Anthony has like a whole list of them online, so you can go check those out.
And then in the afternoon, after our adrenal snacks, we usually do another juice. So like, you know, this is from cucumber juice here that I forgot to drink yesterday. But we'll also do like cucumber apple juice. We'll do like this aloe cooler, which has like aloe and pineapple juice. And you could throw some orange juice in there and then some coconut water.
Yeah. Or we'll just do plain like orange juice. I like to do grapefruit juice, so I'll do that sometimes for myself.
But we were doing, we were even doing like double celery juice.
Yeah, you know, that's a good one too to do in the second.
We did that. We did that for like 9 months straight, every single day. We did 32 ounce in the morning, 32 ounce at night, and that was a real game changer in my healing because, you know, the celery juice really flushes the body, so. All the detoxing that took place from the morning till that second celery juice, the minute I had that second celery, it would flush out any sort of toxins that were developed during the day. And then if you're real sick, you could even, you know, make two heavy metal detox smoothies and have this one after your second celery juice.
Yeah. There's also the ginger, turmeric, garlic shots.
Oh, that's a fun
one. That medical medium, his recipe, that's a really good one. We haven't made that in a while, but we did that for a good amount of time. But yeah, just like juicing any fruits and veggies that you really like is really good for your body. It's a whole nother healing level than just eating the plant itself.
Yeah, you're taking out the fiber, and when the fiber is taken out, then the medicine can take place.
Right.
You know, the fiber blocks the medicine from actually going through the body and helping heal all the different parts.
And you're getting plenty of fiber throughout the day, so you don't need to worry about, oh, am I not getting enough fiber if I don't eat the fiber too?
Yeah. I remember we were even doing one clove of garlic for a while.
We're still doing that, actually. You maybe just, like, it's just part of habit now.
Oh, so you've been sneaking it.
Well, when we have salad for lunch, I will chop up at least one garlic clove each onto our salads. If we do a smoothie, I don't put it in the smoothie. But then I'm, like, trying to incorporate it into dinner. But if we have a salad, there's raw garlic on there. Because it's so powerful. I mean, it's more powerful than an antibiotic. And can do, you know, 10 times the work of an antibiotic.
It's antiviral. So it's going to kill that Epstein-Barr.
And antibacterial. So dinner time. Dinner time is usually when we are bringing in a cooked meal. And typically we'll bring in some fats then. Something to understand is when we say to eliminate fats throughout the day, know that it's like the overt fats, which we will go over. But all like plants and stuff, they contain like trace amounts of fats. So don't be like, oh, but I need fats. Like, right? Don't we need fats to, you know, go on with our day? Yes. And everything has fats in it. But the overt fats that you want to keep out to detox is really important, because once you put those in your body, your body then starts processing things differently and you're not absorbing the nutrients and all those good plant foods like you should.
So where Ashley was going with that whole thing was that we eliminate the unhealthy and healthy fats throughout the whole day. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the only fats that we consume are the healthy fats. And those would be like nuts and seeds and avocados and olives and, you know, we'll cook with some oils here and there, but we try to pretty much go oil-free with all of our dishes, but yep. Sometimes we can't get away from it.
Yeah.
So we eliminate all the healthy fats and unhealthy fats throughout the day. That way we can really keep the detox going. Now, if you're trying to heal and you want to heal at a quick rate, this is how you're going to heal at a quick rate.
Yeah, you've got to keep the fats down.
Because each type of fat remains in the bloodstream for a given period of time, right? The meat products, those are going to remain in your bloodstream for a very long time. The plant-based fats, they'll remain in the bloodstream for a shorter period of time. We did a video on this. Go watch that video if you haven't already. And it explains how long stuff stays in the bloodstream. But the unhealthy fats, the healthy fats, we avoid that throughout the entire day. In the evening time, then we'll usually cook our dinner.
Yeah, a lot of times we're doing like potatoes, that's a big one. Or just like sauteed vegetables.
Last night we had an amazing meal by Chef Ashley. We had some pot stickers.
Yeah, that took
was
a
really
while.
Good.
But it was good. It was a fat-free dinner too. And it was all, I don't know if I told you that, there was no fat in that dinner.
No, I didn't.
It was, the amazing. Dough was like all made out of like potatoes and then I stuffed it, it was with mushrooms and onions. And then the sauce was like lemon and maple syrup and some spices.
And then one of my favorite is the macaroni and cheese recipe.
That's not fat-free, but it's...
It's not fat-free, but it's,
I make it low-fat, though.
Yeah, it's one of those...
Yeah, you use...
Those ones we have here and there.
Yeah, gluten-free pasta, which there's so many out there. I mean, there's ones made out of lentils, chickpeas, there's even ones made out of cassava. And then, like, the cheese sauce, I make it, like, a low-fat cheese sauce because I do half of it out of cashews, half out of potatoes, and then it's some like lemon and spices, and then I put some broccoli in there and it's like really good. So there are some really great recipes out there, and you know, with things that you can nourish your body with so much more. So check out our Instagram, that's where we put a lot of the recipes that we do, and usually share like where we get the recipes from. A lot of them come from Medical Medium. So check it out. We put a lot on our feed and a lot on our story.
And then every once in a while we'll have like a raw meal for dinner.
Yes.
You know, if we feel like we've had a little too much fat, or we feel a little bit heavier that day, or we're coming on with like a cold or flu, then we typically will just have a raw meal for dinner and we feel a lot better. Not as heavy the next day.
Yeah, there's a lot of really good like raw meal recipes that Medical Medium puts out there, like cucumber noodles with, or even like the spinach soup, but like cucumber noodles with like tomatoes and other veggies and things like that. So
yeah. So part of this whole thing is cleansing, right? You're cleansing your body with the stuff we just laid out, but you could take it a step further and try some of Anthony's cleanses that are in his books.
Yeah.
And so we've done the 28-day raw cleanse. We did that twice. We've done the thyroid, you know, healing cleanse option C. We did that once.
Once or twice.
Once
I think
or twice.
It might have been twice.
Okay.
And we've done the liver cleanse multiple times, and he has three different versions of that that you can check out. He also has some other cleanses and cleanse to heal, like the morning cleanse and the heavy metal detox cleanse.
Anti-bug cleanse. Mono eating, you know,
yes,
he's got all sorts of stuff in there.
So lots of great cleanses to also incorporate. And so just kind of see like what you get called to.
Yeah. So there you go. This is how we were eating in a day to heal my Epstein-Barr virus.
Right, and how it's progressed sort of over the years. So we hope that you can take that and modify it to your sort of plan and what works best for you.
But still keep out, like, all those things we listed off in the living room earlier. Keep those things out of your diet, because that's going to make you worse, not better. And you want to bring in the things that we just showed you here.
Yeah. So.